provide a platform in these special times where people from all over the world can come together and talk about COVID-19, the riots, the lockdown, and transformation. So, and first I'd like to introduce to you Jason. Jason is like piloting or floating around, and he's also recording this session. And if you don't want to be recorded, please tell me, and then we stop the recording after the talk of and exercise of Arno. We also, I like to introduce to you Bogdan. Bogdan, where are you? Ah, Bogdan is behind with the smileys. He's also part of the technical service here. And we are really happy that they always help us out. This is our team. I will introduce myself too. And Laurel, of course, she's the co-founder of Educators in VR, and it's really an honor to be part of this platform. So thank you so much for also being here. My name is Dana Maria Faneke, and I've been sailing around the world on big traditional sailing vessels, first as a crew member and later as a captain. And now I make people or help people to become the captains of their lives. And virtual reality is the most powerful tool to help me with my mission. That's why I founded a company called Captain VR. And I'm proud to be part of the Educators in VR. I'm the team leader of the V-Coaching and Personal Development track. And the mission of this track, of this session, of this weekly events is to provide a network of people around the world who are interested in coaching and personal development and provide them an interactive space where they can communicate, share knowledge, support, connect, and inspire each other, and maybe even join forces to create a better real world for everyone. And today's guest speaker is Arno van Dijk. Please give him already a big, big hand. Show him that you're already excited to hear his talk. And Arno van Dijk is born in the Netherlands, and he's done a lot of spiritual development in Europe and India before he met Jeanette Crowling in 2004. And since then he joined Jeanette Crowling. How do I pronounce her name?
Crowley.
Jeanette Crowley, and he's been training with her since he met her and traveled with her to Egypt, Malta, and Norway. And in 2009, he became the first certificate soul body fusion practitioners in the Netherlands or in Europe, even.
This was in the Netherlands, but it was one of the first in the world.
And since 2012, he's also a teacher, teaching other people to teach soul body fusion.
People to use soul body fusion.
And also the other one in 2020, you became the teacher of the teachers.
Yeah.
I confused the two numbers, but we are so proud because you're the one of the best next to Crowley to practice this. This soul body fusion technique. So thank you so much for being here. Give him again a big hand, Arno van Dijk.
Yes, sir. Yes, thank you. Thank you all. Can I already start with what I'm going to tell? So it's really great to see you all in virtual reality. And I really love the opportunity of virtual reality to connect to you. This is really such a special time that we can use technology to connect to people and to be present and to share insights and knowledge. And I don't know what you have already done and experienced in your life on a spiritual level. So I want to tell you, I don't want to convince you with anything. I just want to share insights. And when you say, it's a nice insight, keep it. And when you say, I don't agree, it's okay. Yes, I I've been interested in spirituality since I was a child. I was always questioning, why are we on Earth? Is it, yeah, what is it? And I started doing workshops when I was a teenager, and I'm really interested in raising consciousness first of myself, and now I'm full time. I started my own center, and now I'm full time busy with helping people, raising their consciousness. And I'm a practical person, because reading books is nice and raising consciousness is nice. But what I want is that the effect of raising your consciousness makes you more happy in your life and makes you experience life in a different way. Because when your consciousness changes, you perceive the world in a different way. And that's what I really like about raising consciousness. And it's really the time for raising consciousness, because the whole Earth is raising in frequency. And this is an opportunity to rise with the raising of the frequency of the Earth. And I suppose many of you have heard from 2012, they were starting with things, with ideas about it. The world was going to end in 2012. And what really happened in 2012 is there was an energy shift. And after 2012, it's even more easy to raise your consciousness. And I'm going to talk to you about soul body fusion, which is a technique to raise your consciousness. And there are many ways to raise your consciousness and many ways which help you to be in a high space. For example, being in nature is a very good way to raise your consciousness. And feeling gratitude is one of the best ways to raise your frequency. And in our Western world, we often look what we haven't got, where we haven't got this car, we haven't got this house. And that's a perfect way to increase economy, but not such a good way to raise your frequency and raise your consciousness. Soul body fusion. Soul body fusion is from an American founder. She's called Jeanette Crowley. And Jeanette Crowley has been working with raising consciousness of the planet and of the people since the end of the 80s. And what she does is she gives workshops, she gives online trainings, and her name is Jeanette Crowley, and she has got her own website, JeanetteCrowley.com. And you can join her every week on Monday with an online channeling. And that's really helpful to raise your consciousness. And she has been to a lot of places on the earth to gather wisdom and to do any energy work. And in 2007, her guides gave her this new technique, soul body fusion. And what it does is it makes the connection between your soul and your body stronger. And many people know Deepak Chopra, and Deepak Chopra has said something about the connection between the body and the soul. This quote is also in the Soul Body Fusion book, and the book is available in 10 languages at the moment. And what he says is people keep struggling with problems physically and mentally, and they don't know the reason. And the fundamental reason is the connection between body and soul is weakened. So when we come into Earth, a birth, we have got a good connection with your soul. And when that connection is weakened, you get fears, you get blocks, you get a lower frequency. And when you increase the connection between the body and your soul, it does two things. It increases your consciousness. And when your consciousness has a higher frequency, the world really feels different. It's amazing to raise your consciousness. And the other thing soul body fusion does is it raises the frequency of your body. And that's why many spontaneous illnesses disappear. And that's a beautiful side effect. So people all around the world say they feel stronger, they feel more happy, they feel more healthy. And I learned this technique to people in workshops. I do the workshop several times a month, and I have trained people in using this technique since 2012, and I've trained at the moment more than 1200 people. And I also train teachers since July this year. And I also would like to have you the opportunity to experience this energy. So when I do a session with someone or with a group, because only teachers are allowed to do it in a group, and your own soul's energy gets connected to your body. And it's a process. I am the facilitator. What happens when I start the process is we get surrounded by an energy field. And while we are in that energy field, your soul's energy comes more into your body. And a session is divided in two parts. It's the first part of 10 minutes. Then you get to this virtual reality, normally to the reality. And then we do the second part of 10 minutes. And yeah, I would like you to experience it. Does anyone have a question? Because you can, it's best to sit, because I don't have to the trouble to stand. So it's better to sit in reality. And is there anyone who has got a question before we start? And please raise your hands if you have got a question before we start.
I think they all can speak now. I did not mute anybody. So if you have a question, just shout your question out or say your question. Oh, there's a hand. Testmaster, do you have a question? Oh.
Sorry, everyone was muted because there was background noise.
Oh, I thought that was it was not muted. Sorry. So
no.
Okay, then I have to raise hand button. Okay, sorry. I will use the raise hand button then. Please, can you raise your hands, Testmaster, so we can answer your question and unmute you? Yes. Good. I got it. Let me see. Yes. Now you can talk.
Cool. So my question is about this Crowley, Mr. Crowley, who invented this technique. So this guy actually is a kind of relative of the Aleister Crowley.
It's a she, by the way. Her name is Jonetta Crowley, and she is 66 years old at the moment. She is no family of Aleister Crowley.
Okay, that's all. I just wanted to know.
Okay,
thank you.
And cool. Yeah, you're welcome.
Anybody else?
I have a question. I have a question.
Yes.
I was just curious about what we are to expect. It really helps if we just have a little more, a little more explanation of what we're about to experience.
Okay, that was something I was going to tell anyway, but it's a good question. So it's best when your bodies and reality are sitting, and really it's also helpful when you close your eyes. And many people feel physical sensations with a solar diffusion session. That's how it's called. And the most known experience is people feel a kind of tingling in their body. In Norway, for example, they call this technique champagne healing. And sometimes people feel suppressed emotions coming out of the system. So it's possible that you start laughing or that you feel upset. And those emotions, I always say, are on the way out of your system. So your soul is in charge. So I can't decide, fortunately, what is going to happen. Your own soul energy comes more onto your body and is going to welcome inside.
Excuse me. Sorry, Anno, I hear your voice is cracking a little bit. Can you maybe re-enter the space or do something to with your mic, maybe use the the amplifier in and out? Nope. That maybe works.
Nope, just re-enter. It's a caching issue that's associated with that device. Yeah,
okay.
Re-enter.
Go to settings, re-enter. Very simple. We'll be back in about 8 seconds. Go to your circle menu, go to settings, re-enter. General re-enter. Yep, there. All right. So I want to remind everyone that Dina Maria's V coaching sessions are every Wednesday at this time, or sometimes an hour later. And but do check the schedule, but usually it's around this time. And the topics that she's covered have been over the last 6-8 months, have been phenomenal on personal growth. One of my favorites was having the drumming one was just amazing.
Yeah. Are you still?
Yeah, you sound much, much better. So come around to us and.
Yeah.
He may have re-entered on the backside, unfortunately.
Yes, I was on the backside.
Yes, I'm so sorry about that. We're trying to get that fixed. All right, you sound much better. All right, so make sure that everyone puts it on their schedule that they come back every Wednesday.
Yay.
And she's also explores VR and AR technologies for personal development and personal training and growth and therapies. All kinds of amazing topics, so don't miss it. All right, end of advertisement.
what is interesting about this session is the energy is going to continue to work from inside the next 3 weeks. So the next 3 weeks, you can feel changes in your body and your mental state. You can feel you're more happy. You feel stronger. You make decisions which looked hard before, and you feel from the inside, I can just do that. And this is such a beautiful, simple and fast technique to raise your consciousness. And what I also love is you can measure it with aura equipment, you can measure it with chakra videos, and you can measure it with kinesiology. What's the word in English?
Kinesiology. You said it right.
That's the word. Yeah. You can, when you measure people before and after a session, you can really measure their consciousness frequency is much higher after a session. And I'll just want to let you experience it. And normally in normal life, I've got a timer, and I'll do that also right now. I'll set a timer. And in 10 minutes, I will tell you when I start the process. And then in 10 minutes, I will ask you to return to reality, virtual reality. And like I said, it's good to be seated, your physical body and reality, be seated. And it really helps when you close your eyes. So I'll have my timer right now. Yes. So I'll start the process right now. And just keep your focus on your body and try to notice whether you can feel something inside your body. So I'll be mostly in silence for the next 10 minutes. And you don't have to feel anything. When you just feel calm, it's okay. And now I would like you, with your eyes closed, to focus on your feet. Now you can focus on your whole body again. This part of the session is still approximately 2 minutes. Now you can all return to reality / virtual reality. Dana, can you help unmute when people have got a question or want to share something?
Yes, I will. Oh, that was amazing. Really amazing. For me, I like to share later, but I'm wondering if other people have something to share also and felt it. Did anybody, I think you're all unmuted. Are you, is there any question or do you want to share? Did you feel something? Oh, I do have a question here. Kodil Wumpu. Again.
Hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
Okay, hello. Thank you very much. It's me. Thank you very much.
Yeah, where are you?
For
I don't see
that.
You.
Oh, there.
Ah, there. Yeah. So you changed. I didn't recognize
I don't know
you.
What my clothes look like today, but thank you very much. In the beginning, I found it very hard to not do anything, which of course is ego, so I sent ego out. And in the end, I must tell you, I want to tell you and thank you, I feel warm, I feel warmth throughout my body, and I feel calm and peaceful. So thank you for this experience.
And this is only the first part. The second part is
Are we gonna do a second part?
Normally a session is 2 times 10 minutes, and the first time you dive in the energy, and then you return to reality, virtual reality, and then in the second 10 minutes you can even get the energy can even get stronger because your body is now prepared.
Yes, so I did not know if you're gonna do a second part, but you're gonna do a second part, yeah?
Yeah, when the people are open to it, I would love to do a second part.
Yes,
because the
anybody...
fun thing of raising, the fun thing of raising your frequency is we are all connected to the collective consciousness. So when someone raises in frequency, all humanity is raised in frequency.
Yes, beautiful. Does anybody wants to ask something? For example, I feel really hot right now. I have really hot and hands and feet, a little bit sweaty even. And before I had a really dry mouth, and it's now is it more moisturized. I need to drink some water though. I'm gonna get some water for the second half. But also I felt like something was pushing me back into my body because I was really in the future, almost like doing things and rushing through the one thing to another. And then now I feel like I'm pushed back more in the centrum of my body, and I feel more relaxed and at ease. And also I in the middle of the session I needed to move my neck and head, and it was like to get it more relaxed, it was like going to the tension of my body, and now it's all like more at ease and relaxed. But I am also familiar with this technique because I do it myself every day almost, but especially with you now I feel it more stronger, because maybe that's because you're doing something with me also, not with me, but you are like initiating this.
The technique is stronger when you do it with another person than doing it just by yourself. But for me, when I do this in the morning, I have got a different day. I feel more light, more happy. Yeah, things go in a flow. So I really like it. It's a practical technique to experience a more beautiful life. And for some people who are new to closing their eyes, this might look a little bit like meditation, but it's not. Meditation is really healthy and really helpful. But with this technique, your soul's energy gets more into your body. And Dana Maria, you do both. You meditate and you use soul body fusion. So maybe it's nice if you tell the difference in your experience between meditating and using this technique.
Yes. Yes, I will. And I prefer normally to do soul body fusion over meditation, because it's more effective, and especially because I am I have a startup working with virtual reality. It's also many times a lot to do and running from one thing to another thing, and a stressful life. And then this is more a healing technique, I find. So it feels like it's healing my body and centering my body. So it's really, and I don't have to do anything. With meditation, you also don't have to do anything, but many times I use visualization techniques in meditation for manifesting, for example. So manifesting my future self. And this is more like a different thing. It's like still I'm doing something to focus on something. And here is more letting go with soul body fusion. I feel it's more, I don't do anything. I just let go and things happening in my body. And I don't even have to do make an effort, you know, and this is so special. And I feel something is, I feel, like I said in the beginning to you, I feel something outside myself almost pushing me back in my body to center me. But you say it's my own soul.
Yeah, it's your own soul. I don't transmit any energy. I'm just holding a space, and that space makes it possible for your own soul to connect stronger to your body. And with body, I mean physical body, emotional body, mental body, and spiritual body. Let's have I would like to have a little bit of water too, so let's have a 60 seconds opportunity for people to get some water. So how do we check if people have returned, Sadhana?
Give hearts.
Yes. That's a good one.
Yeah. Bogdan already did it. We are like thinking a light. Cuddle Wumple is out still. Zoe, are you back?
Yes.
Good. Steven? Yeah. Happy Nikone. Apinicone, do I say your name right? He's turning around. He's coming back, maybe. Cuddlewumple, you. She's still out. Cuddlewumple is still out. So let's maybe wait a little bit. I can send her a message.
And if you want to read more about this technique, you can go to Jeanette's website, JeanetteCrowdy.com, and you can also check on my website, but that's mostly in Dutch. That's my name, ArnoVanDijk.nl. And you can also read a book about this technique. And the book is called, depending on your, in English it's called Soul Body Fusion, The Missing Piece for Healing and Beyond. But when you just go to Yunetta's website, you can find all the information.
Ah, great. And Kodal Wampel is also back. So, and there is a hand on the ground. Whose hand is that? Is that your hand?
No, I. That's the.
Ah, yeah, okay. Now it's on the, no, somebody. It, yes,
it's from Julia.
Sorry, Julia. Julia. Yeah, I just was a little bit distracted. Yeah.
And so let's start again. And if you've got any questions, we can answer them after this next session part of again 10 minutes. So your physical body can be seated again. You can close your eyes and I'll start the process right now. So just keep focused on your body. Thank you. And I would like you to focus again on your feet. This part of the session is still approximately 2 minutes. You may focus on your whole body again. You may now return again to reality, virtual reality, and open your eyes when you're ready. And maybe Dan, I can help again with people who have got a question and mute and mute.
Yes, thank you. So you have a raise hand button on the right button side. Yeah, and if you push that button, you can ask a question by raising your hand and I can unmute you. So if anybody wants to share something or say something about the session, please do. We still don't have any questions yet. So don't feel shy to talk right now. Questions? No questions yet. Should I ask a question? So why did you do you is this your only thing you do, or do you work besides this? Is this you do full time?
Yes, Soulbody Diffusion is what I do full time, and I feel really fortunate that I'm able to help people raising their consciousness and make a living. And I do personal sessions, and that's also possible on Skype, on Zoom. So when you want a personal session with me, that's possible. And I also do group workshops on Zoom, but most workshops are still live, because I notice people really love to connect live also. And depending on your own country, there are Soulbody Diffusion teachers. I'm from the Netherlands, but there are physical teachers in many countries, and you can find them on Jeanette's website, JeanetteCrowley.com. That's and when you see the symbol on the wall next to the text Soulbody Diffusion, you see a kind of sun, and that sun represents your soul energy, and the shape around them is from the Egyptian symbol, the crown of Isis, and it symbolizes your body. So the symbol of Soulbody Diffusion is your own sun, your own soul, really connected at the center of your body. So, and when you're, yeah, when you've got that center, you glow from the inside. And that's what I really love. I don't know whether I can translate it into English, but in Dutch we say, our ego makes from mosquitoes elephants. And I always say, Soulbody Diffusion makes from elephants mosquitoes again. What I notice in the morning when I think, oh, I should do this and this and this, and the day is too short and I can't handle it all, then I do 4 or 5 minutes Soulbody Diffusion, and then I feel relaxed. I think, oh, okay, everything will work out, and I'm in a flow, and I feel light. And that's what I really love about this technique. It's really practical for having a better day. I really like the opportunity, Dana, to share this with you in virtual reality, because this is my second time in Old Space, and the first time I'm talking in Old Space. So thank you for this opportunity.
Yeah, you're most welcome. We have a question. Apinicone, I don't know if you see your word name right. Apinicone, you can speak now.
Yes. Hi, can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah, first, on both sessions, I don't feel anything different. I mean, I meditate, so I feel about the same, meaning I feel calm and full awareness about my surrounding. I hear all the sounds, it's raining outside, my AC is running, my fish tank is watering. So I feel the same as I'm like meditating. So I don't feel anything different. That's my first feedback. Second, when you say you're doing this fusion every morning, so I'm just wondering what do you mean doing this fusion? Like when I say, like when I learn meditation, I know I sit down, I try to get things out of my mind, try to be empty, try to stay calm, relaxed, try to breathe, try to kind of focus from my head to my feet. I mean, that's my routine. I know what meditation means to me. But when you say you do this fusion every morning, what exactly you do?
Now, like I said, it's an energetic process. It's an energetic technique. So I just sit or lay down, or I can do it in bed or under the shower. And I just start the process. And I close my eyes and I feel my soul's energy change my awareness. And when you when you are tuned into this technique, you can just start the process with an intention. And sometimes I compare it to using Microsoft Word. Microsoft Word is a very complicated program, but when you've got it installed, you just press the icon of Microsoft Word and then it starts. And when you have read a book or when you have done the workshop, then the process, the soul diffusion process, is installed in your system and you can just activate it every moment of the day. And some people, you don't have to feel it. Most people feel something, but not all. For example, I don't feel any physical sensations, but I feel the energy around me changes when I activate this process. And I also notice the world looks different after I have done this process. The world looks sharper, colors look more beautiful. And yeah, it really depends, but you can measure with aura equipment and chakra equipment that something also happens, but you don't have to feel it.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you for your question so much. We have another question, and maybe the one who raised his hand, maybe he wants to really speak. That is CGM0705. You are unmuted.
So I just joined and I saw this live event once before, but I was in this like tea thing, because this tea, like that tea thing, was in like once a week. Like, what exactly is this?
We haven't got enough time to explain it, but when you go to the website jonettecrowley.com, you can find everything you want to know about this technique, and the technique is called soul body fusion. And also when you use Google, you just press, you put in the text soul space body space fusion, and then you get all the relevant info. But it's a technique to make the connection between your soul and your body stronger.
Thank you so much for your question. So yes, it is time. That is so nice of you that you all came. I want to have a big hand of applause for Arno. Please give him some love and hands to show you that you appreciate him. And we are so grateful that you came today, Arno. So thank you so much. And also thank you so much, Bogdan and Jason, the bot Gambot, Fox Gambot, that you came here also to help out today. We do this as a team, so thank you so much for coming. If you want to stick around a little bit more to maybe ask some questions to Arno, then we wait a little bit more. But if you want to leave because you have to go on with your day, please do leave, and see you next time, next week. Next week we have Sarah Hill. She's a founder of a big startup working with virtual reality meditation, and she founded millions already for her virtual reality meditation experience. So it's also a very interesting topic. So please come next week as well. Okay. Bye bye, and thank you. Oh no, we have to do a selfie for the people. Let's do a selfie with Arno. We almost forgot, Bogdan. You did not remind me. Sorry, Bogdan, it's not your fault. But we always do a selfie. So, Bogdan, are you doing it or am I doing it? We can all do it. Do you know how to do it? So now I'm the only one who is in my own selfie. For sure, Jason can make a picture of us. But what you do, how to do it, Arno, is to mm-hmm. go to the menu button, and under the menu button you see like a person and a photo. If before that.